Today I'm going to show you how to change a flat tire on the side of the road. First, you need to locate where your spare tire is. So for me, it's in the boot of the car. You need to loosen the tool or mechanism that holds the tire. Remove the spare tire from the vehicle. Next, find your tools to be used. For me, it's gonna be the jack, the tool for cranking the jack, and the tool for removing the lug nuts. Now we go to the tire that we were changing. First step is to place the jack where the car spot is for the jack. Some people like to use the frame. Me personally, I like to use where the manufacturers said to do it. There's two indentations where the jack goes. As you can see, the jack also labels that for you. Once it's secured, then we take the tool, place it inside, and use this to raise up the vehicle. Now, you take the lug nut tool and loosen the lug nuts. We don't want to remove the lug nuts, we just want to loosen them. This way the vehicle, just in case it falls off the jack, the tire can still catch it. Next, we continue to raise the vehicle. We're going to continue to raise the vehicle until it is no longer being supported by the tire that we are changing. Next, we're going to remove all the lug nuts. Once all of the lug nuts are removed, stay clean with the tire from the vehicle. Once the tire is removed, then you can successfully place the spare tire on the vehicle. In some cases, the spare tire sits a little bit higher than the regular tire. So all that we need to do is adjust the jack.
Next, we can place the tire on the area, which we are trying to change. Next, we can start to place the lug nuts on. There's a special way to place the lug nuts on every vehicle. So, since ours has five lugs, there's a diamond formation which we use, which is always diagonal from the previous lug nut. Okay, once they're all on, then we can go ahead and start to tighten them. So for ours, we start in the diamond formation. It does not matter where you start, as long as you start somewhere. So from everyone, it is the diagonal lug nut. Since this is a temporary fix, you don't need to torque it down to spec. Just make sure it's very snug, so when you're going down the road, your spare tire doesn't fall off. Now that all five of them are snugly on, now we can go ahead and lower our jack. You want to do this very slowly because this is a lot of weight. You don't want to take all the weight off because they are not torqued all the way down as much as possible. So once again, you can start at any point. Once they are all successfully tightened down, you can then lower the weight off of the jack and back onto the tire. When changing your tire, it's always important to have your hazard lights on, as well as parking far away, or as far as possible away from the road as possible when changing your tire, to avoid an accident. Make sure all your tools are accounted for, as well as your tire that you have changed. And then place everything back where it goes, to avoid confusion and lack of tools for the next time you go to change your tires. Before going on trips or checking it regularly, you should always check to make sure all your tires are properly inflated, as well as your spare tire. And that is how to change a tire on a 2003 Infiniti G35 when you have a flat. Thank you.